Hi, two camera chaps, back again. We're doing really well. We've got 15 subscribers after our first video.
15 subscribers? You told me when I get to 25, I could order a Range Rover. Is that how it works, isn't it? That's what happens on YouTube, isn't it? Oh, is it not?
No.
Oh, okay. What are we talking about today, Lee? Oh, I know what we're talking about. We came to talk about calibration of monitors.
Yeah.
Your grading monitor at home.
Yeah.
How often do you calibrate it?
Oh, if I'm not being lazy, once every 3 months, maybe.
Mm-hmm. And I have here your, I believe this is your Ninja V.
Yeah.
When was the last time you calibrated that?
Oh, that must have been never.
Never. A bit like mine until recently. Until I purchased one of these cables.
Oh yeah, what's that?
That is a USB-C LANC cable. LANC, I think, is a 2.5mm kind of jack plug.
Okay.
It plugs into all the Atomos products,
yeah.
Basically from the Arsumo to the Ninjas to the Shoguns, etc.
Yeah,
and it allows you to at least get some consistency. So when you calibrate it using one of these proper cables, you've got some continuity across the set. I mean, remember that job we turned up on recently? We turned up on the set recently, had identical cameras, identical settings, three ninjas, I think, and a Shogun.
Yeah.
And four different looks.
We put the white balances off in the cameras, but
it was only tiny, wasn't it? I mean, in all fairness, there's a small amount of colour shift between all products and all monitors.
I suppose environmentally, if one monitor sits in a studio, another one goes out on location, different temperatures and stuff, they're going to drift.
And they do. And they drift over time anyway, irrespective of who makes them. They'll do. So, I mean, the best thing we found is that obviously that having one of those cables is a perfect solution to basically at least giving you half a chance that when you arrive back into the edit suite, that what you've seen on set is something similar to what you're going to expect for the person who's going to grade it and edit it. So I'm going to now take you through the process of calibrating the Atomos product using this cable. Of course, know what we are going to need? I need a little bit of footage to put on the display before we run the calibration.
Don't worry, mate. I've sorted that.
Have you?
Yeah. I had the camera rolling while you were eating your lunch.
Oh, right, okay.
So, Stu, what we got here then?
Well, Lee, we got three products here, varying in age at the moment. We've got, in fact, this is your original Ninja, which you've had for a while. The oldest unit of the lot is my original Shogun, and the newest of the bunch is the Ninja V Plus. And I think it's fair to say you can see a variance between those three screens. None of these have been calibrated ever. Fair to say that I think the most true to life image at the moment is the Ninja V Plus, and that's probably understandable because it's the newest, because that one's brand new. This one's the oldest. I think fair to say this one looks probably the most out to me, to my eye, and this is the one that you've been using pretty much on every shoot. So we'll run the calibration process on this now, and then we'll see how close we can get these three and see what difference it makes. So first things first, the tool you need is the X1 Display Pro, which is made by X-Rite. I think this product is actually sold now under a company called Calibrite, but it's exactly the same tool, it's just a newer version of it. And you place this in the middle of the screen, in this case on the Shogun. And when you open the software, you'll be presented with this screen, and you have to, this is the Atomos Calibrator 2 software, which you get on the Atomos support site, available in Mac and PC format. And the first thing you have to do is basically hit the detect button, and that will tell you which device is connected. In this case, you can see it's a Shogun 7. Then you hit calibrate. It goes through initial calibration process. Gives you a little warning saying to warm your screen up and make sure it's switched on to make sure it's all up to temperature. Hit OK. And then it will go through and read its native primary colours to start with. And then go on to the gamma readings, where it's using test patterns to read the brightest and darkest parts of the screen. This process in total will take about 2 minutes. So for the edit point of view, when we get this back in the edit, we'll speed this up to save you waiting the full 2 minute process. So it's nearly finished reading its grayscale process and doing the gamma side of things. When that's complete, it will update the gamma settings on the Shogun. This just takes a few seconds. It verifies those. After a short delay, the calibration will say complete. That's the whole process, just done in just under 2 minutes. Okay, so that's a Shogun done, and now we'll just repeat the process for the Ninjas. But there we are, process is complete. Job done. We'll just do the last Ninja now and see what the results bring.
So, if you're still watching and haven't fallen asleep after that thrilling footage of Stu reading the newspaper,
All three monitors are now calibrated, all looking a lot closer than they were 5 minutes ago.
They are. I've got no excuses anymore for my colour balance is off.
I said 5 minutes ago then, but it's actually taken 3 hours to do this process, to film this.
It's taken about a year, I think.
So until the next time, get your monitors calibrated and look forward to the next video.
I'm going to bed.